Thank you. Greatest of all is the thought that enthralls, that I shall behold my King. Rejoice in His presence, revel in His grace, and ever His praises sing. I'm homesick for heaven, seems I cannot wait, yearning to enter Zion's pearly gate. There never a heartache, never a care, I long for my home over there.
Us. I could just only try to imagine what it is for the family. But one of the things I found comfort in is that we're laying to rest a man of God.
Amen. Amen.
Someone who has devoted his life to the service of the Lord, to his church, to the community. This was a strong man. But he
day
had a strong
by day,
heart of compassion.
And with each passing moment, strength I find to meet my trials here. Trusting in my Father's wise bestowment, I've no cause for worry or for fear.
We welcome you, and I want to welcome those who are joining us on YouTube. The family wants you to know that they appreciate you for the support that you have been giving and continue to do so. We are here to lay to rest a man of God. And we are so happy that even in his devotion to God, he was devoted to his family and to the church and also to the community. I had a talk with his daughter, with Crystal. She said to me, I don't know how he did it, because in as much as he served the church so faithfully, we the family did not miss him, because his devotion to the family was just the same. Some persons have not mastered the art of doing that. You have people who are very committed to their church, but their family suffers. And she told me that the family did not suffer because of his devotion to the church. And so today, as we lay this brother to rest, while our hearts are pained, let us rejoice in the blessed hope. The songwriter says, we have this hope that burns within our heart, hope in the coming of the Lord. We have this faith with Christ alone imparts, faith in the promise of his word. I know it is going home time. And know that Jesus is coming soon. Let us all be faithful and be ready to meet him when he comes. I'm going to ask Elder Carr just to say a prayer for us as we open this ceremony officially, after which we will sing an hymn and I will share with you a brief charge. Elder Carr.
May invite us all, wherever we may be, to bow our heads for prayer this time. Bow our heads, close our eyes for prayer. Our gracious God and our Heavenly Father, we thank you for having provided enduring mercies for us to have come to this place. Lord, as we gather here now, we come at an occasion where we will lay to rest one who dedicated his life to you. Lord, we thank you for the fact that even though we mourn today, we still have a hope of that resurrection morning.
Amen.
And so, Lord, as we come now, I pray that we may find inspiration in the life that Elder Winston McKenzie lived, so that we too, who are left behind, will so seek to live for Christ Jesus that we will have the opportunity of meeting our brother one more time. Continue to comfort the family. Continue to bless. Ask that as we have this service now, something will be said, something will be done, a song will be rendered, where hearts will be comforted, is my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much. I would like for us to sing the hymn, Face to Face with Christ My Savior. This is a blessed, a song that captures the blessed hope. And we hope and trust that as we sing
206.
This song, that our hearts will be comforted. It is number 206.
Face to face with Christ, my Savior.
Face to face, what
will it be? Face to face, what will it be?
When the rapture I behold him.
When with rapture I behold him. Jesus Christ who died for me.
Face to face shall I
behold him. Face to face shall I behold him.
Far beyond the stars.
Far beyond the starry sky.
Face to face.
Face to face in all his glory,
I shall see him
by and by.
Only faintly now I see him.
Only faintly now I see him.
With the darkening veil
between.
What a blessed day is coming.
What a blessed day is coming.
When his glory,
when his glory shall be seen.
Face to face shall I
be. Face to face shall I behold him.
Far beyond the,
far beyond the starry sky.
Face to face in all his glory.
Face to face in all his glory. I shall see him by and by.
On the third verse, what rejoicing in his presence.
What rejoicing in his presence.
When all banished grief,
when all banished grief and pain.
When the crooked ways are straightened.
When the crooked ways are straightened.
And
the dark things shall be plain.
Far beyond the
starry sky.
Face to face in all his glory.
Face to face in all his glory.
I shall see him
by and by.
Face to face.
Face to face for blissful moment.
Face to face.
Face to face to see him know. Face to face with my Redeemer, Jesus Christ who loves me so.
Face to face shall I
behold him,
far beyond the
far beyond the starry sky.
Face to face in all his glory.
Face to face in all his glory. I shall see him by and by.
Face to face.
Thank you. We give God thanks for his blessing. And even though we mourn, let us not mourn as people without hope, because we have this blessed hope to see our Lord when he returns. Amen. As we prepare to transition to the graveside, I just want to leave a passage with you. When we would have established the goodness of God, one want to ask the question like the psalmist David did. He asked the question in Psalm 116 verse 12. What shall I render to the Lord for all his benefits towards me? He said, I will take up the cup of salvation. I will call upon the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows in the presence of his people. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. May God bless us. Brother Mac has died a precious death. And we trust that when the Lord bursts the clouds of heaven, he will be among the saints who will be caught up to meet the Lord in the air. May God bless you as you grieve. At this time, we will transition to the graveside. May I invite the pallbearers to come at this time.
So we're at it. So, Pastor, you're before me.
Sir, let not your hearts be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again to receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. As much as God, in his infinite love and wisdom, has permitted our dear brother, Elder Winston McKenzie, to fall asleep in Christ, we do lovingly commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in the sure and certain hope of a joyful resurrection when our Lord shall return in glory. God will call and he will answer. We will have a desire to the work of his hands. And now, beloved friends, I invite you to bow your head for a moment in prayer. Gracious God, we thank you for the life of Elder Winston McKenzie. We thank you for the service that he rendered to his fellow humanity in his time. We ask that the legacy that he would have left behind will help to mold others and inspire others to serve you. Mark this spot, O God, and when you shall return with the sound of your trumpet, may he hear your voice and rise from his grave to go up with the rest of the saints. Bless us continually. Grant comfort to the family. In Jesus' name, amen. As the workmen proceed, we will continue singing, and we are going to sing the hymn, Does Jesus Care? Sorry, the golden morning is fast approaching. That's number 205, the golden morning. Number 205, the golden morning is fast approaching. Jesus soon will come to take his faithful and happy children to their promised home.
Sing. The golden morning is fast approaching. Jesus soon will come to take his faithful and happy children to their promised home.
Oh, we see the gleam.
Oh, we see the gleams of the golden morning piercing through this night of gloom. Oh, we see the gleams of the golden morning that will burst the truth. The gospel summons will soon be carried to the nations round. The bridegroom then will cease to tarry, and the trumpet sound. Oh, we see the gleams of the golden morning piercing through this night of gloom. Oh, we see the gleams of the golden morning that will burst the
attended
by all the shining angels, round the flaming sun. That judge will come and will take his people where they
We're going to sing one more hymn, number 211, Lo Ye Come. What is saint? That's the one we want. What you saying? Number 598. What you saying? With eyelids waking, lo, the powers of heaven are shaking. Keep your lamps all trimmed and burning, ready for the Lord's returning.
What he sings with eyelids waking, lo, the powers of heaven are shaking. Keep your lamps all trimmed and burning, ready for the Lord's returning. Thank you for your lovely singing. I want to thank you for your support and all you who have joined on the support on YouTube. We appreciate the support that you've been giving to the family and ask that you will continue to do so. We're going to ask at this time. Hello, Williams will at this time give us the closing prayer.
Shall we pray? Let's pray. Almighty compassionate Heavenly Father, we thank you, God, that we are alive and remain. We thank you, God, that our dear brother McKenzie is in your hands. We thank for the life he lived. We thank for the examples he set. The legacy of God will last for a long time. And we pray, God, that you would mark the spot so that when the clouds shall be burst and the Son of Man shall come to claim his saints, Elder Winston McKenzie will be at the forefront to hail you as King and Redeemer. This we ask in Jesus' blessed most holy name. Amen.
Thank you, brethren. Thank you. And we wish for you a safe journey as you go back home. And just to let you know, friends, that we are going to be having the memorial service on the 18th of this month. We will send out the link, so please look forward to that. Look out for that on the 18th of this month. May God bless you. All the best. Thank you.